Leo Brauer, RARA, Deutsche Grammophon 2002. Considered as one of the most important living composer for guitar music, the Afro-Cuban composer, classic guitarist and conductor Leo Brauer was named Julian Leopoldo Brauer when he came into the world in Havana, Cuba, on March 1, 1939. His enormous influence on guitar music in particular and classical music in general is demonstrated by more than 100 recordings in which he has played, composed or conducted. Brauer's composition reflect classical Afro-Cuban jazz and avant-garde influences. His many film scores have brought his music to the attention of a huge audience around the world. Brauer's influence in his native country results in part from the important position he has held in Cuban music institutions. In 2002, Deutsche Grammophon reprinted as a single CD two important LPs, Werke für Guitar Solo, von Gaspar Sanz, Luis de Narváez, San Fernando Sor, Cornelius Cardwell, Hans Werner Henze, Leo Brauer, made in 1971, and RARA, made in 1973. The CD contains almost all the contemporary music included in the two LPs, with the missing of Gaspar Sanz, Luis de Narváez, and Fernando Sor music, but with the better quality recordings. During the 1960s and the 70s, Brauer became interested in the music of modernist composers such as Luigi Nono and Yannis Xenakis, using indeterminacies in works such as Sonogramma No. 1. Other works from this period included the guitar pieces Canticum 1968, La Spirale Eterna 1971, Parabola 1973 and Tarantos 1974. This CD reflected this interest. It showed Brauer as a performer recording music by Silvano Bussotti, Hans Werner Henze, Maurice Ohana, Cristobal Hafner, José María Mestre Quetreni, Girolamo Arrigo, Juan Blanco and Brauer himself. Brauer's playing career ended in the early 1980s due to an injury to a tendon in his right hand middle finger. This CD is very interesting for two reasons. First, it continues the same musical journey made by records like Julian Bream's 20th Century Guitar. Second, we can enjoy Brauer's ability as an interpreter. Hans Werner Henze, as also Pierre Boulez, Wolfgang Fortner, as also Maurizio Kagel, have made use of the instrument and assigned it a special function in the timbral structural context of their works. The composition appearing on this record represent a cross-section through today's leading musical avant-garde. Common to them all is the subordination of overall music form to strict structural arrangements, which are derived from the specific sound material. Common to them, however, is also the fanatical experimenting with the potential of sounds, up until alienation through interfering noise and sounds, produced on purpose up until the limits of technical ability. Silvano Bussotti's composition can therefore serve as a prototype. RARA Ecoseriologico are in fact five pieces in one for violin and or viola and or cello and or double bass and also guitar. It's according to Bussotti's intention a composition in five variants, through off as a concert cycle which develops over several days. For each concert, one variant only will be performed, and so on day by day until the fifth. On the sixth day, a complete performance with a united five section is envisaged. The principle of freedom of choice is not only applied to the overall form, but is also used as an aleatoric structural impetus. The third of five pieces, sounding the same for all five instruments, is written in graphic notation. On the record, only the solo part assigned to the guitar is performed. RARA can define an aesthetic position. I use every form that helped me to develop musical forms, Leo Brauer once explained his aesthetic views to an interviewer. This form could be those of a leaf of a tree, or they could be geometric symbol. Although my pieces really appear highly structured, it's principal sound that interests me. One of the best examples of this approach is La Spirale Eterna, 1971. Brouwer's standing point was a quotation of the physicist J. G. Guidreau that is preface to the score and that refers to spiral structures in the macrocosm and to the occurrence of similar structures in the microcosms. In the organic world, the spiral is found, for example, in multiple fruits of sunflower, in snail shells, and in the smaller living organisms. Setting out from a cell made up of overlapping over semitones, Brouwer generates a different kind of spiral-shaped rotatory movement in each of the work's four sections. In the first extended form of the cell, together with other variants, are arranged around a mean value in terms of compacts, register dynamics, and length, thus creating the impression that they are rotating around it. In the second section, Brouwer's focus is attention on brief arpeggiated figures grouped around individual sforzato nodes. What we might call the central axis and of the third section is the fingerboard itself. Here the guitarist's two hands abandon their usual function and produce percussive sound of no specific pitch on the fingerboard, drawing closer, crossing and moving apart again. The first section culminates toward the end of the piece in expansively ascending and descending broken chords, their wave-like form once again suggesting a spiral. In his early works, Cristobal Hafner followed in the footsteps of Manu de Falla in his attempt to create a stylized abstract Hispanicism, whereas in the 50s he had embraced a musical language that reflected the influence of avant-garde post-serial techniques, without, however, abandoning his Spanish roots. From the 60s onwards, Hafner has sought to combine both styles within a single piece. He is aiming being, in his own word, to Latinize surrealism. Codex 1 dates from 1963 and is Hafner's only works for solo guitar. Although his middle section is largely concerned to create its impact through its use of sonority, Hafner uses traditional sounds, with the exception of some glissando passages and the percussive effects of the crossed bass strings. Among these traditional sounds are harmonics playing near the bridge and rasgueado, a method of stringing the strings borrowed from flamenco. It's left to individual performer to decide how long to stay over particular passages. In the outer section, by contrast, the pitches and note lengths are strictly organized. The opening section uses 12 note techniques to weave a contemporary texture. With a basic set, you can listen to it at the very beginning and contains the note of the open guitar strings in odd numbered position, used as a starting point for four further sets. Rhythm 2 is treated serially, with different speeds allotted to the various layers, thus producing an impression of rhythmic instability, even though the rhythm are in fact strictly notated. By the way of contrast, the text section is dominated by a rhythmic uniformity, distributed only by a gradual quickening of the basic tempo. The guitar occupies an important piece in the works of Hans Werner Henze, who has repeatedly used it not only in larger and smaller ensemble, but also as a solo instrument. He was attracted to the sound of the instrument by the jingling and the whimpering of the nerve fibers, the hundred colors, the dark and shadowy and silvery sounds, the sound of weeping and hollow cries as the nocturnal animals and the son of history. But, quite apart from his function as a gate through which we can approach the root of music, Henze also sees the guitar as an entirely modern instrument, capable of inspiring a style of writing that is full of technical music innovative features. Henze's aesthetic understanding presupposes not only a pronounced awareness of tradition, Now that this requires him to compose in traditional ways, but also the belief that thanks to his unambiguous linguistic character, music can communicate specific non-musical ideas. This belief has been reinforced by Hans' sense of political commitment since the late 60s. Hans Werner, as also Pierre Boulez, as also Maurizio Kagel, had made use of the instrument and then assigned a special function in the timbral structural context of their works. The composers appearing on these CDs represent a cross-section through yesterday's leading musical avant-garde. Common to them all is the subordination of oral music form to strict structural arrangements, which are derived from the specific sound material common to them, up until the limits of technical flexibility. Thanks for watching. Please support and follow NoiGuitars.com.